So good morning, all of you. This is a student during exams, and don't worry, we've all been students. We've all gone through this. This is from the Bible. I walk through the valley of shadows of death. At exam time, we all are extremely scared, and in that scare, we forget our basics, which is unfortunate. And that's what we are here all for, because all these ophthalmic subspecialties require a structured patient examination of common case scenarios. Nobody will fail residents if they just answer the must-know areas. Good-to-know areas may not be answered, but must-know areas should be, which should be a tailored history taking, basic examination with diagrams. In your case presentation, always put a diagram with color pencils. Okay, that will score many marks for you. Like for fundus examination, you should have an AMSLA chart with diagrams. For cornea, for gonioscopy, just put the diagrams in. Additional investigations, and then we have a commonly asked questions. So this is my expert team, Dr. Ratanam from Aravind, she'll talk about uvea, myself from Guru Nanak Eye Center about cornea, Dr. Madhu Bhaduria for glaucoma, Dr. Amitava from Aligarh Medical University for strabismus, Dr. Krishna Kumar for orbit, and Sagarika Patel for neuro-ophtha, and Shalini for glaucoma. Okay. No one can whistle a symphony. It takes a whole orchestra to play it. And that's what I have with me today. So these are the scenarios we'll be covering. Fear has two meanings: forget everything and run, which most of us want to do at exam time, or face everything and rise. Choice is ours. So let me start with the corneal session. Cornea wala laga dijiye, please. Can I have a pointer? How many of you are residents here? And how many of one? Oh, that's good. That's fine. Morning session? That's pretty good. So good. This is structured for you. And how many of you are exam going residents? Okay, so some of you still have time. That's fine. So what is the examination technique which you're most afraid of? Till my slides are on. Cornea Valley, please. Dr. Kirti Singh ka lecture. Yeah. What is the one which is most terrifying, or most, not terrifying is the wrong word to use, most difficult? Sorry? Squint. Yeah, squint. Same for me, actually. It was the same for me. Cornea is one of the easiest, but please remember, cornea case will always be given to you. Exam, viva, topography, drugs, everywhere cornea will come. So, algorithm for corneal exam is, please, in the corneal exam, don't forget the adnexa and lids, the meibomian glands. Please start my time now, sir. Aapne pehle, hello, audiovisual people, please. Timer start kar dijiye ab, because aapne pehle wale ka timer kar rahe hain aap, introduction ka. So, algorithm, adnexa and lids. So, please do evert the lid. That's my first tip to you. When you're taking a corneal exam, lid evert. Do evert the lid, because you will otherwise miss out on the papillae and other things. To the roplas. Very often we'll say, roplas, oh ma'am, we forgot. That's part and parcel, okay? Corneal shape, clarity, size, sensations. You may not have an esthesiometer, none of us have it. You may not have a cotton wisp. You have to tell the examiner, I wanted to take the sensations, I could not, okay? Opacity, of course, all of you know. Carry your fluorescein strips with you just in case the examination hall doesn't have one, okay? And of course, slit lamp. So let's come to slit lamp, that is the basic. We all know the seven types of examination: direct, diffuse, focal, indirect, specular, and the sclerotic, scatter, and retro. Out of these, the focal and the diffuse is the most important, and then you must go for specular because of shortage of time. If you have any problems in the corneal opacities, then go for retro examination, okay? In the algorithm, in the cornea, even if it's a cornea case, do a tonometry. Don't think that it's not a cornea, it's a glaucoma case. It's not a glaucoma case, tonometry is not required, because very often herpes or corneal opacities, PKs, you would need a tonometry along with it. Then, this is the viva things. You won't be asked to do these in the exam, but keratometry, topography, specular microscopy, ASOCT. The viva will go on these things. Okay, these investigations, basic. Why, where keratometry, why not keratometry, because only central zone is taken. Pentacam, what's the principle of pentapan, shim flux, obscan and coronal topography. Obscan and pentacam are the latest things you should know about them, because these will come in the Viva Voces also. You'll have invariably topography map there with them. These colors, remember, as I said, I stress on diagrams and most examiners do. Black is limbus, scars, degenerations, foreign bodies, sutures, contact lens and BSKs. Okay, so you should carry your color pencils. One diagram is worth 1,000 words. Okay, that diagram will speak for you. And you can't undo it, you can't redo it. Okay, brown is pigmentation, Krukenberg spindle, pupil and iris and iron or melanin pigmentation. You have to draw it on the cornea, the back of the cornea. Color blue is for edema, diffuse is stromal edema, and small circles is the epithelial edema, okay? And wavy lines, moment you do that, is Descemet's. If you have this diagram, the examiner will not even ask you anything, go through it, and then you will have a DViva, okay? Because they realize that you know about it, okay? Red is blood vessels. Deep are the straight. If you draw a wavy line, it means superficial vessels. If you draw straight lines, it means a deep blood vessels. Okay, rope staining also is in red. Again, rope staining is not very frequently given to you in the exam, but they can be asked. And hemorrhages, of course, which is not a very common thing to see. Orange is hypopyon, and KPs also, fresh ones. Now, orange, you will not rarely have a case with hypopyon, very rarely, unless it's the other eye. You know, other eye may have a hypopyon. You won't be given an active corneal ulcer to see. Green is fluorescein staining, any epithelial defect. The viva will go on the vital dyes and the non-vital dyes. Punctate epithelial keratopathy, filaments are small lines, okay? So, and green dots are punctate keratopathy, and the shades are epithelial defect. So color pencils, green, red, brown, black. And so this diagram, take a picture of this. This just shows you all the colors and how to code them. So the first message going to you is lids to evert, second roplas, third corneal diagrams. Clear so far? Okay. Then fourth is corneal opacities. These are three ways of depicting opacities. Nebular is shaded or stippled lines. Macular is straight lines. And leucomatous is standing and sleeping lines. And adherent leucoma will have a brown circle like this, which means the iris is adherent to it. Size of the opacity, you can very easily measure on this slit lamp graticule, but please do remember for the examiner, you must magnify it depending on what lens you're using. For the slit lamp, of course not, but if you same thing, you're using the graticule for the disc examination, you must put the magnification factor in. So let's get to this brief video of what we've talked so far. So diffuse elimination, okay? Just have a look at the cornea. Lids, you are meanwhile seeing, you have averted the lids, you checked for roplas, okay? Revert the lids, look for the palpable conjunctiva, okay? Limbal dermoid, very obvious. BSK, very obvious case. Granular dystrophy, very obvious case. KF ring, not so obvious, you'll have to look for it. This ulcer, you will not get in the exam, but you should know about it. Hypopyon, corneal ulcer. Okay, so this all will be seen in diffuse. Focal, make a paraplegia. Okay, look for KPs, look for scars, look for lattice dystrophy. Okay, and look for pigmentation. And very often you'll have a case of lamellar corneal keratoplasties. That will be visible on the focal. Okay, this is a case of lattice. You can see the lines. This will be very clearly seen on retro also. So learn to do these step by step so you will not miss out things. When you go back to your places of work, do these step by step so that in the exam it becomes a spinal cord reflex, okay? Retro, this is the retro technique. You will see the dislocated or subluxated lens very well. You will see a conus, okay? So retro also is very useful in the corneal exam. Torchlight, leave it for the last. But do it, because Rizzotti sign is very often missed. And torchlight will give you the Rizzotti sign. Eclipse sign will tell you about the angle depth. Okay. DDO, Charlex oil droplet sign. Okay. You will see in the conus patients with DDO. You will see RD with DDO. You will see cataract with DDO. You will see corneal opacities with DDO. So DDO is one of the most important things, and this comes as part and parcel of examination. Evaluation of the cornea. Now coming to very briefly about few case scenarios which were giving the exams with some Viva questions. always you will get some case of keratitis, healed, never active. Okay, so please, when you have an act, or if you have rarely an active case, do not do a contact test. Do not do tonometry, do not do sensation, and do not do any touch technique, and tell the examiner, I did not do it because this is active ulcer. That will give you brownie points. Okay, then non-healing, the viva will go on non-healing ulcers, complications, perforations. Hyperpeon, as I said, again, very rarely you'll get a case. You'll get a spotter, actually. When you get a spotter like this, the question will go on to which organisms pass through an intact epithelium, which you should know. Okay, and what are the types of fungi or the types of virus which infect the eye? The viva very often goes on to neonatal conjunctivitis. That case is never given to you, but you should know about that. Herpes are very often a case scenario. You'll have a healed herpetic case. The answer very often people make a mistake is, which is the commonest herpes infection? The answer would be dendritic. The answer actually is thoracic shingles. He has not asked you ocular. If it's ocular, yes, then you asked about ocular. But if the question is commonest herpes infection in the body is thoracic. Okay, then all the epithelial stromal, HSZO, herpes zoster ophthalmicus, is a protean manifestation. It can affect any part of the eye. Okay, and the treatment you should know about. IK, if the patient is of IK, the viva will go on HEDS trial, role of triggers, topical steroids, oral acyclovir. So you should know the HEDS 3 trials. The SCUT trial, the recent trial, you should know about these 2 trials about the corneal cases. PU case, again, you will not get a question, most probably won't get a case, but always you'll get a topography map on these. Okay, so the kissing crab appearance or the beaked appearance of the parrot's appearance, that is very typical of PU case, okay, with the with pellucid. So you must identify these topographies, okay, and then you can talk about the management of topography and the viva. Invariably, if it's PUK, it'll go on Mouren's ulcer. So types of Mouren's you should know about. This case will very often get, again, trauma, aphakia, usually co-linked. Okay, then the types of trauma, how do you manage your trauma? And once you get a trauma case, the viva goes on to dangerous area and sympathetic ophthalmia, okay? Then foreign body removal, hemosiderosis, chalcosis, ERG, and everything, you have to know about that. So trauma is, again, a case. Limbal cell deficiency, very common case. Acquired case, you should know all the classification, you know, the management, primary and secondary. Aniridia, again, can be a case in itself with a corneal case, with a limbal cell deficiency. Treatment should be known. Types of chemical burns and types of classification, Duhas classification or the Hughes classification, whichever one you're using. Okay, the staging of that. Dystrophies and degenerations, again a common scenario. Retro should be done. You'll have granular, lattice, or macular. Any other can come. Epithelium can also very rarely will come, but mostly it'll be stromal dystrophies. VK's case, specular microscopy should be done, and you should tell them if you can't do it that is too dense for me to do a specular reflection. Okay, and VKC case, child, very often you get a VKC case. You should know about VKC and atopy difference, and this is, again, examine, these are viva questions or spotters. BSK, Bittott spots, Pfister classification, vitamin deficiency. These are must-know areas. Again, these are all must-know areas in the vivas, okay? Viewophthalmos, very rarely you'll get this case, but if you do, then it's a cornea and a glaucoma combined, and tonometry is usually not possible, so digital tension you should do, okay? And in any glaucoma case, you should talk about the amblyopia treatment. Keratoconus, again, a must case. Always I've discussed about keratoconus already, the staining, the fit pattern. You should know about the contact lens fits, the types of contact lens, and how the fit changes post-high drops and how and collagen cross-linking. Okay. Flictons and OSSN, that's more into ocular surface, and you will get that. Dry eyes, ek slide aur hai. On kar dije. Dry eyes, this is a drug viva actually. Invariably, this will come in the drug viva. With the drugs, you'll have to cover dry eyes and then it'll come as a spotter. Keratoplasty types, DMEK, DALK, DISEC, indications, rejections. You must always differentiate rejection from failure. How is it too different? Failure can be any cause. It can be glaucoma, it can be dry eyes, it can be primary failure because of the poor graft quality, whereas rejection is only immune mediated. Vital stain characteristics, these staining. Again, this diagram, if you draw with a dry eyes patient, you've done the viva well, okay? So to conclude, in the year of 2020, we all expect you as residents to walk through the exam with 2020. Thank you.